proof that this is gonna be such a good video. There's literally a rainbow casting on my makeup bag right now. Hello, you guys. In today's video, it's a super fun one. My camera's gonna die because I was filming for so long. I have found the best drugstore products to give you a luxury Sephora look on a budget. So keep watching because I got some really good tips for you guys. All right, and we're rolling. We're gonna start doing our skin. So very first, we're gonna use the e.l.f. Halo Glow. It just gives like a nice shine. Like I like to have more of a dewy look. I used to be very matte. I started using this underneath and it's honestly made the biggest difference in my makeup. I've never used the Flawless Filter, but I've heard this is like the best dupe for it. They also have the contour wands, which I haven't used yet, but I really wanna try them. I did use the Charlotte Tilbury contour wand. Honestly, I didn't love it. I did use it for contouring. I think I still have it. I got it like 2 years ago. So that shows you I didn't love it. It was fine, but maybe I've heard good things about the e.l.f. one. So first we're just gonna blend in the e.l.f. Halo Glow. Blend until you can't blend anymore. Also, I'm using the e.l.f. Ultimate Blending Brush. Okay, I think we're blended. Next, foundation. So I always put it on the back of my hand, which I am that girl, shout out if you're the same, that I'll put it on the back of my hand, I'll put it on my face, I'll do my whole makeup routine, and then I won't like wash it off, and then I'll just have like this foundation circle on my hand for the whole day. Well, I wash my hands obviously, but like it just like stays on there and I need to start cleaning that off because I'm like, I probably look like so dirty because I'm not cleaning that off my hand. And the girls probably see it and they're like, I see you with that foundation all over your hand, girl. When I get ready, I feel like I have to listen to music or I can't concentrate. For you guys, I'm not listening to music and I'm just like mindless thoughts. I'd say my biggest makeup inspiration has always been Kylie Jenner. Like I have literally tried copying her makeup routine since she came out with that one video. I think it was like 2020. Maybe it was 2020, I don't know. She came out with this makeup routine. I was like, I'm obsessed with you and I have to redo your makeup every single day. And I still do the same makeup routine that I've been doing with the same products for years. And I really wanna start switching it up because as you're gonna see later, I always do eyeliner and I think I wanna stop. I love the look of it, don't get me wrong. The problem is that I can't just do a simple makeup look. Like if I'm doing my makeup, I have to do every single step or I just don't feel like my best. And I wanna find a makeup routine that is like simple, that still makes me feel good. Then I do this and then see like, there's just foundation and no. After I finish my foundation, then we are going to use this concealer. As you can tell, like she has been through it. Like, she's been through it. And I'm gonna say this is not my favorite concealer, but it's a good one. It blends well, but I've had my friends use it and they say it kind of creases, so I don't know if I'd recommend this one, but it's what I'm gonna use for the video because all I have. But I do use it in like two shades lighter. Any concealer I always use as a highlighter, so I put it on points that I want to like pop. So under my eyes, in like, I think it's called the T zone, correct me if I'm wrong, and I'll put it like here, here, you'll see. So I just like to use it more as like a brightening. Here and in the middle. I wanna like look super awake and bright and happy. Also, I have lots of veins on my eyelids, so I'll cover that up as well. Just like that. I think I need to start singing a song. You know what song I should sing? Tell me if you have watched Saltburn, okay? Because I watched Saltburn with my friend, shout out Hannah. And the whole time, she loves those types of movies. Any of those like psychological thrillers scare me, I think, the worst. Like I can watch a murder movie, I can watch horror movies, thrillers, ghosts. Like I'll be scared, but I won't, like I'll be fine. Like I'll, honestly, I was the person that would watch scary movies alone at night. But for some reason, psychological ones freak me out and really just like disturbing. So Saltburn was definitely that, but it was so good and I can't stop. You guys know that edit of Jacob Elordi, you know the edit. I know you know that. I know you watched it 10 times already today. It's just like, it's so good. Jacob Elordi, if you're watching this, I've never seen that edit, I don't know what you're talking about. To make sure it's fully blended, I'm gonna use the e.l.f. Ultimate Blending Brush again. Also, I don't have perfect skin, so obviously there's always imperfections, especially if you don't have the beautiful glass skin, but I'd say this does a really good job. Next step, powder. We use three different powders, you guys. First step is we're gonna use a loose powder. The one I use is the e.l.f. Halo Glow Setting Powder. I've used quite a few different drugstore setting powders and I've honestly found this one to be the best. I've used some by NYX, Revolution, used a lot. Oh, and I've used the Morphe one. I don't ever buy the Morphe loose setting powder. That is like the worst setting powder I've ever used. And I used it because I didn't want to waste it, but it was so bad and I was like, I can't wait for the day I'm done with setting powder. And then I got this one, and this one was actually really good. Then I used my Eco Tools powder brush and I just put it again where I want to highlight. So I'll pat it under my eyes. Do-do-do-do-do. Here, forehead, like in this area. And then I will use the Maybelline Fit Me powder. Put this like all over my face just to kind of set my foundation in place. Just like that. Then I'm going to use my bronzer, which is by Essence. This is broken. I've had this for 2 years, I think. My mom got it for me in my Christmas stocking, and it just is, it's honestly really good. And it smells like tanning oil, or like, you know, like the sunscreen, but like the good smelling sunscreen. Anyways, I use this brush. A long time ago was by e.l.f. and now it's by No Name apparently. And I just pat that and contour slash bronze, whatever your heart desires. Cheekbones, chisel out that jawline, a little bit down my neck, my forehead. We want to turn that forehead into a three head, you know what I'm saying? After that, I will contour my nose because I've hated my nose forever. Like literally since I was a kid, I hated my nose, my siblings. Obviously you make fun of each other when you're siblings, and they always made fun of my nose. In high school, I got a lot of comments on my nose, especially Ask FM. Shout out if you know Ask FM, because that was honestly literally just used to bully. I hated my nose, and then I got to high school, and then it was like grade eight, I think. Grade eight, grade nine, Ask FM was a thing, and I got so many nasty questions on my nose. And then kind of through high school, I was like, whatever, whatever. Then I went on a live stream with Rice Gum, and everyone was calling me such mean names and saying like, I'd be pretty without this huge nose. They kind of popped off, I'm not gonna lie. Like they popped off on me. It was like 25,000 people were watching, just going in on my nose. It is somewhere on the internet. I think someone literally screen recorded it and reposted it as Vancouver baddie goes on live stream with Rice Gum. I remember finding that, I was like, okay, I thought that was the funniest title, but they went in on me. So I contour my nose a lot. I contour my nose a lot. I don't know if it really helps. I think it does. Anyways, it looks crazy right now, but I promise we're gonna blend it. But something I always do is I go on the top and I just go back and forth, kind of like in a rounded, kind of like a semicircle, to like make it look like I have like a more upturned nose. We are now going to blend out this contour with my leftover foundation that's on my disgusting beauty blender. We are going to bake with the cutest little puff that my friend Hannah gave to me. I think you can get it on Amazon. I think she got like a big pack of them, and it's just so cute. So we're gonna go down the sides of my nose and past my eye to make it look like an uplifting cat eye facelift sort of look. Boom, really chisel out the contour. Lovely, isn't it? So from this point on, we are going to do brows. I love having my brows done. Very like, I like a nice, clean, sharp brow, but not too much. I'm not trying to have that Anastasia dip brow look, but I don't want like the supernatural fluffy look. Like a perfect in between. My go-to brow product is this NYX pencil in shade Espresso. It is the micro brow pencil. So I always do the same thing when I do my brows, and I start at the very beginning and I'll do the whole underneath and I'll extend it just a little bit. I like to keep it, I don't like to do it down. I like to extend it more straight to again give me that kind of lifted look. And then I'll brush my brows completely down and I will do the front and I'll go in here and kind of connect it. I'm gonna do my brows and I'm gonna come right back because I literally can't, I can't look in this. There's like a perfect crack in the screen right through my brow and I'm like, no. See how I haven't filled in that part yet? And it looks really terrible. It's gonna get better. I take, oh, there's one product in here that isn't drugstore. I think maybe it could be. Maybe you can get Morphe at Walmart. Because there is one thing I use that is Morphe. And it is this one brown shade. If I had any other eyeshadow, I would use that for the sake of this video, but I don't. This is literally the only eyeshadow palette I have and own. So we're gonna use it. But I take this brown shade in the middle, and I've had this for literally years, like the colors are gone. Now I'm looking, I'm like, I don't remember breaking this, and this looks suspiciously freshly broken. And like, I swear that was there like last week. Anyways, I take this middle brown color in this Morphe palette and I put it into the very beginning of my eyebrow and then I brush it through with the brush on the other side of my brow pencil. Wow, look at these brows. They're not done yet. They're not done yet. Don't start complimenting quite yet. Don't compliment me quite yet. It's gonna get better. Take the other side of your pencil and just like brush it through so that they look like you tried, but like not too hard. Like that's what this combo does. It's like, oh, they're on fleek, but they're like naturally on fleek. You know what I mean? So you're just gonna really brush it out to give it that airy look, that fluffy look. That is my brow tutorial. And that's the end of the video. Kidding. Next step is eyes. This part is very fun. First thing we're gonna do is I take the Halo Glow powder, the same thing that's all over my face, which we should probably get off now, and we're gonna put it on our eyelids so that the eyeshadow that we do put on, it just goes on very smoothly. So I kind of just like really cake it on there, like so. Then what we're gonna do is we are going to take our bronzer that we used. I didn't say before, but this is in the shade 02 Sunny, and really get in there, like fill it up, tap it off, start in the front of my eye right here, and I'll blend it back like so. I'll take more and I'll start at the corner and I'll blend it outwards. That also, I have these things under my eye in case you're wondering what these weird little dots are under my eye. It's called milia and I've had them since I was a little wee one. So I'll just keep going in until as dark as I want it, and I'll do the same on the other eye, and then I will also take it and I'll blend it up towards my brows. That's pretty much all the eyeshadow I do, and usually I would leave it at that and I will just like focus it obviously here and more on the outside to kind of give it just a smokier look. But we're gonna use my Morphe palette again and use this shade right there, focusing just on the outside and blending it a little bit into the crease. Just to give it more dimension. So that's pretty much everything for my eyeshadow. And then I use eyeliner. And eyeliner I'm actually addicted to. I have to wear eyeliner if I'm doing my makeup. I've tried so many and this is by far the best drugstore eyeliner I've ever used. It is the NYX Epic Ink Liner in brown. I also have it in black, but I find the brown one just makes it a little bit softer. And it's waterproof. Always start at the base and I'll go up and then I'll connect it down. I can't do this on camera because I know I'll screw it up. So I have to do this off camera and I'm gonna come back. I'm actually sweating after that. I used to make my eyeliner super long and super thick. Literally, I think I would do it like out to here and it would be so thick. And looking back, I'm like, what was I doing? And so now I like to keep it shorter and thin. I realize less is sometimes more. And that is definitely the case for me and eyeliner. Next step, CoverGirl Lash Blast Volume Mascara. Don't buy this mascara. And if you use this mascara, we have different eyelashes because this mascara honestly sucks. Again, it's the only mascara I have and I bought it, so I don't wanna waste it. So I'm gonna continue to use it until it's gone or dried out and crusty. But I hate this mascara. Like, it's not good. It doesn't go on well. It's not what I look for in a mascara. So I wouldn't recommend it, but we're gonna use it. Okay, I have 3 steps left. I did this really fast because my camera's gonna die and I don't have my charger with me. So next is blush. And I use the Maybelline Fit Me in shade Rose. Best drugstore blush literally ever. I know where you love to put your blush. I like to put my blush a little bit higher under my eye and really blend it up. And I also put it on my nose. So I do that. Very, very last step, and I'd say my favorite step. Blush is probably my favorite, but lips, I just, my makeup is completely completed. My makeup is complete when I do my lips. You're gonna see, this is the before. And the after is just way better. These are the best shades, best brand, best everything for lip liners from the drugstore, and is the NYX Pencil Lip Liner. Very good price too. Natural is the best thing ever. I wanted to gatekeep it, but you should get it because it's so good. And then the other one I use just to make it a little more pink is Nude Pink. So I will go in with this one, line my lips, and then I'll put this one in the center. There we have it. This is the perfect makeup look using only drugstore products. Turns out perfect every time. Like, I swear, this is the best makeup routine. And It's all drugstore, so it's all super affordable. So thank you so much for watching. I hope you enjoyed this video. If you did, give me a little thumbs up. I really appreciate it. If you have any questions, leave it in the comments. I'd love to talk to you guys. And that's it. I will see you next time. I love you all very, 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 very much. One last thing is if you have any video ideas you want from me, I would love any recommendations, anything you like to watch, find interesting, entertaining. I'd love to make that for you. Any story times? I really want to start doing story times. I feel like that'd be super fun. I have a lot of crazy, weird stories I could definitely share with you guys. So if you have any ideas that you want from me, you ask for it, you want it, I will give it to you. I want to make you guys happy because you're my best friends. Need one thing to end this video. Literally, look what I search up. Never be left. And it comes up with the Lordy and Saltburn. They get it. Please just look me in my face.